There are people in the barbarian society that feel very strongly that we have become what we have become because we have been subject to corporal punishment.
For us in the Caribbean, corporal punishment is a way of life. It is a way how we have disciplined our children, and we think it worked.
All studies shows it doesn't work. Violence is increasing, and they are losing what they call control of children at schools. Now, UNICEF, what we believe is more important is to make sure that children are well-rounded, well-developed, but also it's discipline. And I think it's just different way of teaching and working with children than just beating them with a stick.
Most barbarians believe in the tenet that if you spare the rod, you spoil the child. Therefore, it is going to be very, very difficult to change those attitudes.
When a child receives corporal punishment, he or she does not believe that that parent loves them. Violence is never viewed in a positive sense.
I don't really like to see children being hit sometimes, but sometimes you don't. I don't really think it's right according to what they do.
The public truly believe that if you, in my words, beat children by using the sticks or physical or mental abuse, that's the only way to make sure that children are well behaved, well educated, and is ready to face the future.
I do understand the concept and what they're trying to achieve here by finding alternative strategies to corporal punishment. I'm no longer to attempt to administer it, but use the behavioral wheel, which we use throughout the school, as a means of reinforcing and altering the child's behavior. Everyone starts on green every day, and then if your behavior is adverse slightly, you go on to yellow. If it's worse, you go on to blue. And then for severe behavioral problems, you go on red, in which case you go directly to the principal.
Change in education happens slowly. Change in cultural orientation happens even more slowly. And I think you are going to have a generation of people who recognize the damage that corporal punishment can do to be the persons in the forefront of encouraging change.
We have to get away from some of the old ways of doing stuff, of doing things. Things that, as they say, we grew up with, but may not necessarily have been right. We are always on a quest to improve, intellectually, spiritually. And right now, I think that this system has improved me as a teacher.
Mr. Pilgrim is really an understanding teacher. At one time, I used to be afraid of him.
When I first came here, I can honestly say that the children were, I will use the word, frightened. They were a bit apprehensive because I was very strict and I did administer corporal punishment. However, switching to this alternative means of punishment, I have found that the relationship between the class and myself has become extremely, extremely, it is better.
No, I am not so intense. I don't have to watch myself. I can talk to my friends. I can be myself. I can show my personality.
Children seem to have gained the confidence to say what's on their mind because they are not afraid of being shut up with corporal punishment.
Very good. Give her a big hand.
We speak of having children who develop as critical thinkers, and they can't develop as critical thinkers unless we give them the opportunity to speak, to ask questions, to give their opinion, and so on. And that is one of the things, that one of the positive developments we have noticed from the Child Friendly Schools Project.